Feast your eyes on the Hawthorne Hotel. Established in 1925, the hotel has since gone through several renovations. Every day, the hotel raises a different nation and a different state's flag. Why? Who do we talk to about these different things?
I'm the general manager of the hotel. I'm generally aware of everything.
Okay, jokes. I like you already, Claire. Now, tell us about these flags.
We're not only recognizing the entire nation and the entire world, but also to let the local citizens and the guests have an understanding of each country and to salute each country. And in the lobby, we actually have the definition of the flags, as well as some characteristics and some facts of each nation.
The Hawthorne Hotel was named after Nathaniel Hawthorne, the famous writer who wrote The Seven Gables, The Scarlet Letter, as well as many other stories I was supposed to read in high school. Whoops.
His statue is actually across the street. It was moved here from the Museum of Fine Arts in the 20s, and they raised additional funds to move that statue from the Museum of Fine Arts to Salem, Massachusetts, so he's looking at us every day.
Throughout the Hawthorne Hotel, there are plenty of historical photos. Many of them are from when the hotel was built.
We actually have a picture above on the second floor of our first bride, Lucretia, from 1925.
The Hawthorne Hotel has several different event spaces, one of which is the basement level library.
It was actually once called the lower deck when I worked here as a waitress in the 80s. The background of that room would be islands and like you were in an actual ship because it's actually shaped like a ship.
Shaped like a ship? You could also say this hotel is in ship shape.
There's been so many memories and events that have been held here. I think for many people that have visited the Hawthorne, as well as citizens of Salem, it is basically about the memories that have been created here, and we're very proud of that.
In addition to wedding receptions and corporate events, it just wouldn't be Salem without something a little supernatural. The Hawthorne Hotel also hosts seances and psychic readings.
If you're clairvoyant and audiovoyant, there actually have been feelings that there is a presence here at the Hawthorne. I believe that Nathaniel Hawthorne, of course, is always here looking out for us.
Just to be clear, Nathaniel Hawthorne is looking out for you, but that doesn't mean he's going to bring you extra towels or give you a wake-up call. But it does have me wondering, are the rooms haunted?
I wouldn't say they're haunted, it's spiritual presence. But the sixth floor, the third floor, a lot of people have felt that presence on those floors.
I wonder if Claire is clairvoyant. Well, I know at the very least she is Claire. And I know she knows everything about the history of Beats to the Hollywood elite.
Bewitched was filmed here in 1970. They actually spent a week or so in Salem. They actually stayed here as well as the crew and the cast. Elizabeth Montgomery stayed here. They had an event here for the crew in the ballroom, which we have a menu in our lobby of that event and saw the pictures of Elizabeth Montgomery and the cast as well as her husband.
Not only has the Hawthorne played a role in Hollywood productions, the hotel is also part of Salem's character.
The Hawthorne Hotel represents Salem, period. It was actually founded by citizens of the community in 1923. They started to raise money through the Salem Chamber and the Salem Rotary Club, and it was actually built through stock of the citizens of Salem as Salem's People's Hotel.
This is Eat, Play, Stay. Stream for free only on Very Local.